Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Today's game is between the Iowa State Cyclones and the Kansas Jayhawks. And as we get set to tip off, let's take a look at two of the players we'll be following tonight. And of course, our starting lineup.
Guys, check out the power forward. These kids are fun to watch. Talented, possess enough skill to carry their respective team.
And before we tip off, let's see what these two sides are going to be focusing on today. The Jayhawks get possession and away we go. Looking for a good shot. Fires off the mark. Gets the rebound. Clint handles the pass. The Cyclones, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
Wiggins receives the ball. He can't get it to go. Pulls it in. McCarty handles the feed. With 10 to shoot on the shot clock. Comes up empty from deep. Clint receives the pass. Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. They work the perimeter. In the lane. No. Rebound inside. Shots up. Up and in. Ha ha! On the left side, he strokes it. Want to thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Gus Johnson, and joining me, the man with all of the insight, the governor, Bill Rafter.
Put a little English on it.
The Cyclones are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post, Raf.
Well, anytime you get a player on the high post, you can make plays, you put pressure on the D. That can lead to some easy open looks.
And he can't get them out. They work it around the perimeter.
How about that elevation?
On the right side. Jump shot. Shots off.
Seeing, reacting. How alert, Gus.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Can finish. Down on the low block, trying to work it inside.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
In the post. Fires and hit. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. He missed it.
What a coach will be happy with that effort.
Now they work it around the perimeter. In the lane. Shots off. Inside. Power jam. He's a good inside presence who can step out to the perimeter and knock it down.
I'll tell you, Gus, when you have guys who can score down in the box, also step out and convert, what do you do defensively? You can really cause problems in the matchup for the D.
In the paint. And lays it in. What a pass on the backdoor cut, Coach.
That was just a great cut and feed to complement the move, Gus. The best part about it is that it capped it off with a basket.
In the post. In the lane. Off the mark.
He owns the window.
Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
Defensive rebounds are essential to a running team.
Receives the pass in the paint. Fires. No.
Oh, competitive, Gus.
They work the perimeter. And he can't get the bounce.
What a rebound. I own it.
In the post. Jump shot. He missed it. Grabs the rebound. Out on the right wing. Look at the crowd, Raph. Talk about home court advantage. Talk about a tough place to play. They're on their feet. Dump it inside. Fires.
How about that, Gus?
Get it down on the low block. In the lane. The sophomore. Now they work it around the perimeter. Off the mark. Kept alive. And he lays it up and in. They work the perimeter. In the lane. The senior. In the post. Jump shot.
Perfect.
Down on the low block. And we'll get a change of possession. The Cyclones have been putting on an offensive clinic.
Because, you know, this game can be so simple when you do it right. Balance on the floor, making the right pass, and shooting high percentage shots.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Fires. Nice. Wide open for the shot. In the lane.
He got it.
This guy is a complete player in the post.
He really causes problems, Gus, for the D. You have to double him, and that creates havoc on others.
Try to pack it inside. Jump shot. He can't get it to go. On the outside. go.
Oh, physical play.
Around 8 minutes remaining. Fires and answers. Dump it inside. Jump shot. Count it. And he can't get them out. He shoots from the top of the circle. Shots off. Grabs the rebound. Lobs it. And we'll get a change of possession. Let's get another look at the layup.
You've got to make these inside ones because they're high percentage shots. They've just got to be completed.
We are at the 7 minute mark. Takes the pass in the paint. Shots off. Pulls it down. Way out on the right wing. In the lane. The junior. Now they work it around the perimeter. Shots off. Cleans the glass. Top of the key. Minutes left on the game clock. On the outside. The shot clock down to 10. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy. Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the left side. He unloads a three. It's almost like there's a lid on the basket. They're having a tough time with these rims.
They can't get anything to drop. These guys have hit rock bottom. Their confidence at the moment couldn't be any lower.
Out on the right wing. We're at the 5 minute mark. Got it in the low block. In the lane. Well, coach, is a timeout forthcoming?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there, guys. They're really out of sync.
In the lane. He missed it.
They've got to fill the lanes now. Get out and fill, please.
They work the perimeter. Turnover. They'll go the other way. They work it around the perimeter.
Elevation!
Looking for a good shot. Jump shot. Off the mark. Takes the rebound. Now they work it around the perimeter. Now we've got a turnover. They work the perimeter. He shoots from outside and misses. tup it inside. He shoots from the corner. Weathers buries the tray. Get it down on the low block. Fires the junior. 3 minutes left on the game clock. On the outside. With 10 to shoot now. With the big shot. No good from three-point range. They work it around the perimeter. Jump shot. Can't get it to go. He got it up and in. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Cross court. He tries the three. And he hits the three. Now they work it around the perimeter. We have a change in possession here. And let's take a look at a player who's been all over the court.
He's in the zone right now, making good decisions and being strong with the ball. Coach has got to be pleased with his performance thus far.
Finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. This one's coming in from the baseline. He makes the block. He rips it down. And that's a jam. On the left side. We are at the 1 minute mark on the outside. Inside. Turnover, they'll go the other way. The Cyclones in a hurry. Shots off. Hungry for the ball. They work it around the perimeter. He fires away.
Bucket.
He just needs an inch to get that shot off.
Really a great stroke by this kid.
They work the perimeter. Call for the foul. And there's a look at how these teams have been doing so far. Your first year playing college basketball has to be exciting.
This year's going to be a big year for this young guy. He'll be smart, he'll latch on to a few of the upperclassmen until he gets the hang of things.
No good. Shot. No. we stand after one half of play. The road to the Final Four coming up next. Let's take a look at our game summary to this point so far.
You can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Here's a look at how both teams are doing with their keys to the game.
Gus, it looks like they're going with the minimum.
On the inside. Up and in. Ha ha! In the post. And he can't get them out. They work the perimeter. Decision there by the senior. Rises. He missed it.
Transition.
Out on the right wing. Turns it over. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Put a little English on it.
On the right side. Off the mark.
And he looks to outlet.
On the right side.
Fire. How about this kid, huh?
This guy is really known as a power guy.
When he gets it down deep on the box, this kid can knock it down.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Shot clock shows 10. Dump it inside. He tries to beat the buzzer.
Just look at that block. Terrific reaction.
Can't get it to go.
Get out and fill.
Looking for a good shot. In the lane. And he hits it. They work it around the perimeter. In the lane.
How about that?
Out on the left wing. Cross court.
It's mine!
On the right side. And it's knocked away. Great block. On the right side. Turns it over. On the left side. That play, they went through the high post.
Whenever you're attacking a zone or man D, it's key to get the ball in the center of the floor, and in particular to the high post.
On the wing. Fired. And he gets it. Working around the perimeter.
He goes for three.
That's how to stretch the defense, Cus. If you can make those, offensively your team becomes really difficult to guard.
Cross court. Jump shot. And he can't get the bounce. Rips it down. Looking for a good shot. Fired. Shots off.
Makes them so competitive on the glass.
Out on the left wing. In the lane. He missed it.
I own it.
They worked the perimeter. Now we've got a turnover. Unusual mistake there by the senior. Dump it inside. Jump shot. Shots off. What a rebound. On the outside. Up a long range shot and no, nice pass to the low block. Fires.
Big time dagger.
On the left side. Looking for the bomb.
Oh!
They worked the perimeter. Called for the foul. Raf, so far it's been a demonstration of teamwork.
When everybody wants to win, everybody will do what it takes to win. That's what we're seeing, Gus. Five guys making the moves they need to get the victory.
Here's another solid junior build.
By the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's about leading by example and guiding the younger players on the team.
He makes it. In the post, in the lane, off the mark, pulls down the rebound.
Way to stick it, young fella.
Sensational dribble penetration, Bill.
Gus, he put the ball to the floor with conviction and drove it home.
Jump shot.
Got it!
On the right wing. Careless mistake there. Anderson on the move. Watch out. Bam. Out on the left wing. Fires.
How about that, Gus? Got to admire the kids with that middle game. The ability to shoot the mid-range jumper. Must be able to pull it up and knock it down.
On the right side. He can't get it to go.
They should look to push it now. A little woo-woo, Gus.
Way out on the right wing. Shot clock shows 10. He puts it up quick to beat the clock. No, what a rebound. We are at the 7-minute mark. And lays it in. A great finish on that backdoor feed.
Oh, what an explosive cut to the tin and just a terrific feed. What a finish, Gus.
In the lane. Shots off. Give it here. Try to pack it inside with the answer. On the left side, jump shot. Shots off, rips down the board. On the low block, and he lays it up and in. 6 minutes left on the game clock. Entry pass in the paint.
Magnificent!
Top of the key. Turnover, he'll want that one back. Pushing in transition. Sands with the ball.
What a rebound! It's mine.
Anderson handles the pass. Fires. And he can't hit the shot. He nails the bucket. 5 minutes left on the game clock. Sands receives the ball. In the lane. He gets that one to fall. Dump it inside. Wide, wide open. Nails it from downtown. Bill, I've heard you talk about it before. How about the number of baskets which have been scored in the paint?
The closer you get the ball to the hoop, the better chance you have of making a hoop. Clearly, they're playing with the mindset of getting the ball into the paint and finishing strong at the goal.
Ball coming in from the sideline. 4 minutes left on the game clock. looking for a good shot. Out of bounds and a change of possession. And while we have a moment, let's take another look at our star matchup.
There are a lot of things that don't always show up in the stat sheet, Gus. These guys could have a horrible game up to this point, so long as they step up and make the big play when called upon.
Crossley handles the feed. In the lane. Shots off.
Get out and fill.
Anderson receives the pass. And he answered. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that. Wouldn't you agree, Coach?
Wow, Gus, when you drive it with authority, only good things happen. Drives like that usually end up with a basket and or a foul.
Jump shot. He doesn't get the hoop. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Low block. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. In the post. In the lane. Good. Down on the low block, trying to work it inside. Buries it. They work the perimeter. He swats the ball. Anderson receives the ball. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Down on the low block. In the lane. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Dooley handles the pass. The freshman. Willis receives the ball. In the lane. It won't fall. York handles the feed. Blocked! 1 minute left on the game clock. Sang receives the pass. Jump shot. He can't get the hoop to fall. And they burn a timeout. We'll have more NCAA basketball coverage in a moment. And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. On the left side. He shoots from the top of the key. He gets the shot to fall. Out on the right wing.
A little clock management now, Gus. You have to foul in order to stop the clock.
And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Not much else they can do. Gus, I think they'll keep fouling until they're back into this game.
They're set to throw it in from the side. And yet another stoppage, and yet another foul.
And why not?
They'll throw it in from the side. Wiggins takes the pass. Foul, and that stops the clock again. At the line. No doubt about it. And we're ready. And we're back. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. Out on the left wing. He shoots from the corner. Barely. And the foul will stop the clock momentarily. Tough team to foul because they shoot such a good percentage from the line.
When everyone on the floor can convert from the line, it makes this team very tough, especially down the stretch. The opposition is trying to foul.
And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. On the left side. He shoots from the left side of the circle. And he misses the shot. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
Well, Bill, this young man's now in his second season of eligibility.
Gus, he's been through the first year. It's going to be exciting to see how much he learned as a freshman. His team definitely expects more from him this season.
No, not this time. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. On the right side. He shoots from the top of the circle. He can't get the bucket to fall. And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
What else they can do?
Now they'll line him up. Foul shot not good. Braxton gets the pass. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. And he can't hit the shot. And here's a look at our players of the game.
Ah, some great performances here, Gus. These two were special and really stood out.
On behalf of the CBS Sports team, EA Sports crew, and Bill Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson. Thanks for watching.